This gospel passage about the 72 disciples is something that is unique to the gospel of Luke. But what we want to realize is that to the people of first century Palestine, that number was significant because 72 was, in their way of thinking, the number of all the known nations in the world at that time. So not just the 12 are sent, who obviously would be sent to the 12 tribes of Israel, but the 72 are sent to preach the kingdom so that that good news would be revealed not only to the chosen people, but to all the world. So the gospel poses a challenge to us to appreciate that when we are dismissed at the end of Mass, we're not getting off the hook for another week in regard to our religious practice. Rather, we're being sent out into the world to try to bring the ways of the kingdom to all its inhabitants. But we don't have to rush up to Logan Airport after Mass to go to some foreign land to fulfill that mandate. No, really, we only have to go as far as Stop and Shop or Roach Brothers or CVS to do so. And there's no intent at all to cast any shadow on their business practices, but only to say that that's the marketplace. And so these public places are where the people of the world are gathering. And I'm afraid, if you haven't noticed, do take note. If we're among them long enough to notice, we'll detect at least a fair amount of godlessness. Some of it's obvious, as when recently in the parking lot of a supermarket, one of our parishioners encountered a person who observed a pro-life bumper sticker on her car, and so asked in a rather negative tone, "Are you a Christian?" And when the parishioner readily replied, "Yes," she was hatefully given one of the most crass of suggestions, which cannot even be repeated here in church. But rather than return the hostility in kind, that parishioner tried to remain outwardly calm, though obviously was inwardly shocked, because this wasn't a young person displaying her hostility in such a vulgar manner. But a lot of godlessness doesn't always get that explicit, does it? Rather, it's the competition for space for the carts and limited aisle space, the race to the take a number dispenser at the deli counter, or the race to the shortest line at the checkout counter, or the grab of that last carton of half and half that's on sale that you intended to buy but apparently only were meant to hold open the dairy case door for the one determined to grab it ahead of you. Yeah, there's all kinds of self-centeredness and thus discourtesy, and often outright rudeness on display in the public square. And this is where we, as the disciples of Jesus, are meant to bring the gospel. Indeed, to pray for our persecutors rather than swear back at them. To go the extra mile by yielding our space, our place, or that coveted last available sale item to others. By bringing civility, and yes, even love, by frequently trying to say things like, "Excuse me," or, "Oh no, you go ahead," and "Thank you" to the others, rare though they may be at times, who may show some sign of courtesy in return. Well, what will that gain us, we might ask, other than to make us doormats to be walked on? Well, just as selfishness, competition, hostility, and rudeness can breed more of the same and create that dog-eat-dog atmosphere, so too, on the other hand, can gospel attitudes and actions, such as cooperation, kindness, courtesy, bring to the world the ways of that kingdom whose coming we pray for each and every time we gather here as God's people. So be it in the marketplace or on the roadways, let us try to be conscious agents of God's kingdom, lonely though that might be at times, developing the discipline that is true discipleship, to always try to take the higher road and not respond in kind to words and actions that are in the least impolite, sometimes outright hostile or offensive. Rather, diffuse them with mercy and kindness, and to face any outright hatred with love, as we attempt, as those on a mission, to transform whatever corner of this world we might find ourselves in at the present moment, in accord with the ways of Jesus as found in his gospel.